Let's get into it.
Welcome to the Kandid shop.
Yeah.
We speaking on things you not. Just press play and let it rock. Hey, welcome to the Kandid shop. Whoa, welcome to the Kandid shop. We speaking on things you not. Just press play and let it rock. Hey, welcome to the Kandid shop.
I feel like we going through mad things. Gotta keep it real when they choose not. We gonna talk about it when the news drop. Welcome to the show where you know we don't fake this. Keep your opinion to yourself if it don't make sense.
Hola, podcast family. It's your girls, Candidly Kristen and the Grounded Tyena.
Hey, here, hey, hey.
On a very special and important episode of the Kandid Shop podcast. We were scheduled to do an episode on mental health, but in light of the untimely and tragic passing of Earl Simmons, a.k.a. DMX, we decided to switch it up and do a discussion about addiction. Now, we're going to touch on primarily drug addictions, but there are a lot of other things you can be addicted to out there that are just as bad. So we're going to briefly talk about those too, but mostly we're going to focus on drug addiction, drug abuse, and the many faces of addiction. So here we go with,
you know, we hold everybody, like, you're responsible for what you do. And yep. I get that.
Right.
I get that. But sometimes you need help.
Yes.
Sometimes you need help.
Yep.
Sometimes you don't know what it is. Sometimes you go through things in your head and you can't really put your finger on it. And I think when you're going through it personally, you can't get out of it.
Right.
Right. You know, when we hold these doctors responsible to, when we make a conscious decision to say, I need this help, I'm coming to you, this is my situation.
Mm-hmm.
What is their responsibility? How far does it go? How deep does it go to help that person?
I think any meaningful recovery should be medical and psychological.
Mm-hmm.
Because there are, number one, medically, because there are things that drugs do to your body that you need to,
mm-hmm. adjust.
To adjust to. And that could, even if it's not a pill, you need to eat right.
Mm-hmm.
You know, drug users don't eat.
Mm.
And when they do, it's usually not healthy.
Right.
So your body is lacking in a whole bunch of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And then psychologically, to dig down into why are you doing this? Because most, the average person that's a hardcore drug user didn't wake up and say, yep, I'm going to be a drug addict for the rest of my life.
Mm-hmm.
You just don't. You make a choice one time and that turns into something else, and you make that first choice based on whatever your lived experience is,
mm-hmm.
whatever your trauma or whatever you're lacking or think you're lacking,
mm-hmm.
or lacked in your life. You know, this is, we have to have a follow-up session because we are so over time.
Are we?
Oh, my God.
Oh, man.
Are we? We are over time, but I don't want this conversation to end here. I think it's far too important. I know we got real candid and a little personal, guys, but that's just what happens.
Hopefully
when
somebody can, you know, resonate and understand that,
yes.
You know, they're not alone.
You're not alone. We're going to do a follow-up to this, and we're going to pull in the mental health component and see how mental health and substance abuse kind of go hand in hand and look at some of the stats for that and discuss that. But before we go, yeah, don't ask. I don't have it. I don't have the tagline yet. I don't have it. I don't know. I'm having a brain freeze. I don't know. But I wanted to give out this 800 number. It's for SAMHSA, National Helpline. It's 1-800-662-4357. This, you can call this number if you or someone you know is experiencing some kind of substance abuse crisis or you just want some help. It's confidential. It's free. You can get info about treatment, public health agencies that can help you on your road to recovery and being recovered. So again, that number is 1-800-662-4357. And as we wrap this up, I just want to say, you know, I'm a number one. I was DMX's number one fan. I wrote him in prison and the whole nine.
Yes, you did.
His loss kind of weighs heavy on my heart, and I just want to send his family and his children our thoughts and prayers from the Kandid Shop podcast to them.
Yes.
And I want you guys to know that if any of you under the sound of our voices is having some kind of issue, you can DM us. You
Inbox.
Can And on Facebook, Instagram.
Yes, please.
On the website. Reach out, and we will try as much as we can to point you in the right direction to get you the help you need. So, with that,
I do want to add, hugs heal.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes Somebody just needs a hug,
mm-hmm.
and somebody just needs to know that somebody cares. One person.
One person.
And, you know, if anybody happens to think that somebody is struggling, give them a hug.
Let us pray for those that we've lost.